Hi guys, it's Rachel, and I'm going to be doing my review today on this game, which is The Sims 3 Supernatural. It came out in the UK on Friday, although I got it on Saturday, because Amazon, I don't know, they made a... whatever happened, I didn't get it on time. But the good thing was I did get a refund on the delivery charges, because I pre-ordered it on Amazon and I chose for guaranteed release date and delivery, and it wasn't delivered on release day, which sucked. But they did give me a refund very quickly, and just a refund on the delivery charges, and I got my game delivered to me the next morning. So yeah, what I think about the game. Okay, well, so far I really like it, and yeah, usually I'm not a big fan of supernaturals in my game, but I've actually found that it's actually quite fun. Witches, I really like. I've had a chance to play about with that, and I think that it will be quite useful to have a witch in my household, and a fairy. Werewolves and vampires, I haven't really played with a lot. Well, I've played with werewolves a little bit, vampires not so much, because I'm not really sure exactly what vampires have to offer in the game, given that they were also in Late Night, and they annoy me because the whole town is a with Late Night, basically it's like the whole town is vampires, like every person is a vampire. But with Supernatural, there is an option to turn off celebrities, zombies, werewolves, to turn off, well, to stop them from spawning so much in your game. They will still appear, but not in as big numbers. There's also zombies in your game, which, if you got the limited edition Plants and Zombies version, like I did, as you can see, you will get a pea shooter, which basically shoots peas in the game. No, shoots peas at the zombies, which will basically put them to sleep for a while. Just like in the Plants and Zombies game for iPhone and iPod Touch. I assume it's also available for iPad. But yeah, I think the fairies are really cool. I like the fact that you can play with their wings. Yeah, you can choose what wings they have, what colour they are, and I think they're really cool. So there is that. The potions sorry, I'm getting tongue-tied. The potions are really cool, and it's fun to see their effects. One potion that I like is the Flask of Bees, although I've not actually used it on another sim, only like the sim that created the potion. But basically it makes a big swarm of bees come and attack your sim. But I would like it if the game offered more for non-supernatural natural sims, even though the game is primarily focused on supernatural sims. It would be nice to see a few more interactions for normal sims. But the game did come with 5 new traits. Well, I don't know if it's 5. But let me think. Night Owl. There is Brooding, which means your sim likes to contemplate the hollowness of life. supernatural skeptic, supernatural fan. And is there another one? Night owl, gatherer, supernatural fan, supernatural skeptic. And there might be another one, but I can't remember. There's also a few new options in KTSim, as well as a new trait. You can edit the jaw underbite, the ears orbit. So if you've got a fairy, then you can give them like really pointy, like pixie ears. There's a few new accessories, tons of new clothes, and lots of different hairstyles as well. And there is a ton of new objects, including a little train set. There's a magic 8-ball, a claw machine. It's just what's coming into my head. A smackinome machine. There's also an alchemy station, which works very similar to the chemistry station that came with Generations. Except you're making, instead of potions, elixirs. Which can have positive or negative effects on your Sims. There's also the Broom Arena, which is awesome. Witches can ride brooms, and I think all supernaturals can. I'm not sure if normal Sims can, but I will check that out. There's lots of new furniture and new decorative objects. So if you are a builder or you like to decorate your Sims homes, then there is a lot of that. There is Newtown, which is called Moonlight Falls, and it's basically focused on supernatural. Another thing which I'm going to talk about is the lunar cycle. This is basically the phase of the moon, and when it's a full moon, this is when it will have an effect on your Sims. Although what these effects are, aside from the werewolf, I haven't really explored it much. But all in all, I actually really like it. I don't love it as much as, say, Pets or, I don't know, Generations maybe, but it's still a great game, and I am looking forward to the next expansion pack, which is Seasons. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this little review, and I will talk to you guys in the next video. Okay, bye.